Hi, I'm Derek Briggs, Tsugami Product Manager. Today, I'll be explaining weight codes and their unrivaled importance to multipath programming, specifically on Swiss type lathes. Let's get started. So when it comes to a Swiss machine, typically they're at least two path and sometimes three path, maybe even up to four path. The most typical is two path control, so we're gonna start there talking about weight codes and how to program weight codes and what their use is and the benefit of a weight code. And really the absolute necessity of weight codes when it comes to multipath controls. So for example, if I have my main path, we'll call it main. Some people call it main and sub. Some people call it NC1 and NC2. Some call it main and back. Whatever the nomenclature is, it's all the same. It all means the same thing. One is gonna handle a certain number of axes and one is gonna handle another certain number of axes. Typically, main is gonna be X, Y, Z, 1. And sub is gonna be X, Y, Z, 2. And now, for example, some machines might not have a Y axis on the sub, so maybe this is omitted. Maybe it's just X and Z, 2. But regardless, you need to communicate between these two because this side is running its own program, while this side is also simultaneously running its own program. And without communication, these axes can run into each other and you can cause a collision. So the way we prevent that is with weight codes. On a Tsugami machine, our weight codes are let's do this a little bit better, M500 through M699. So you have 199 weight codes or 200 weight codes that you can use. And basically how these work is on the one path, if it reaches a weight code, we'll call it M500, it will sit right here on this weight code until this path reads the same weight code, so M500. As soon as this path reads the same one that this one's waiting on, no matter which one arrives there first, as soon as the second one reaches and they match, both programs are gonna take off again and continue to do whatever they need to do next. So let's say you had an M501. You did some machining here, and this is sitting here waiting on M501. If the next weight code on this side does not match the number and it reaches a weight code, the machine will alarm out with a mismatch weight code alarm. It needs to be the same weight code on both paths so that when they hit, they continue moving on. So that's how a two-path weight code system works. And you can go in any order. It does not have to be in numerical order. You don't have to say M500, M501, M502, M503. You can skip around. You can go to M650. You can go to M550. And then the next one's M585. It doesn't matter what order you put it in, as long as they match from path to path. That's how weight codes work on a two-path control. Now, when it comes to three-path control, we can add another path. So if we go to three path, we'll just draw it a little bit below here. And it works, it's a little more, slightly more complicated, but we have this we're gonna call NC1. And we're gonna have NC2 and NC3, okay? Now, one thing I'm gonna point out, and this is gonna be, let's say XYZ1. X, Y, Z, 2, and X, Y, Z, 3. So now you have three different coordinate systems that can all possibly run into each other if you don't time it right with weight codes. Super important for a machine with this much going on in a small work area. So I'm gonna point out the P codes for three-path control. This is where it gets a little bit more complicated than the two-path. But still, M500 to M699, that is all the same. There's just a P code at the end. So path 1 is P1, NC2 is P2, NC3 is P4. Now, first question everybody asks is, of course, why is that a 4 and not a 3? The way these P codes work and how the weight codes communicate is by adding the P numbers together. So 1 plus 2 equals 3. So you can't have path 3 equal 3. It has to equal something different. So how this works, let me go in a little more detail here. If I want all of these to weight, it's M500 P7. M500 P7 and M500 P7. 1 + 2 + 4 = 7. In order for all the programs to continue, if this one hits M500 P7 first, these will continue to keep working, and this will sit until this one and this one reach M500 P7. Now, what do you do with the other communications here? Let's just say I want my subspindle to be running while NC1 and NC3 are working together on something. Now I'm gonna do M501 P5 and M501 P5. Okay, so now 1 + 4 = 5. So these can continue to have weight codes back and forth, communicating with P5s, all the different numbers. It doesn't matter what order. And this will continue to run and do its own thing. Same thing with path one and path two. If I want this to sit until these are done, I'm gonna put this on M502 P7, and these two will continue to work together, and they can say we'll call it M600, doesn't matter what order we go in here, P3 and M600 P3. Now these two are only communicating back and forth, and this is one is waiting for all of these to reach, sorry about that, M502 P7 and M502 P7. So you have 1 + 2 = 3, that's these two talking to each other while this one does its own thing. You have P5, so that's 1 and 3 talking to each other while this one does its own thing. Then you have P7, where all three have to see it to continue on in the program. And that is how three path control weight codes work, 1, 2, and 4. So some quick tips for weight codes, just basically for program cleanliness and ease of understanding the program. I try to personally avoid jumping all around in numerical order with my weight codes. It's a personal preference. If you want to do that, that's perfectly fine. But it makes it a lot cleaner and a lot easier if you start your program in the beginning stages with M500, and then the next weight code, instead of jumping right to M501, maybe go to M505, and the next one M510, and the next one M515. Now, if you ever wanted to go back and edit and say add a process in between these two weight codes somewhere in here, now you have M506 all the way to M509 without having to go backwards in numerical order. You can actually add 4 more weight codes in between each one of those. Same thing with the 3-path control. You can do it the exact same way. Another method that I use, if I end up say going in order of 500 to 550, and then I want to add something in between there, and I went right in numerical order, what I'll do is I'll start at M600, and then everything M600 and on is everything I've edited after the initial program, writing the initial program. So then I can kind of go back and find it very easily, what I've added and edited within the program afterwards. And then if I wanted to, I can clean that up fairly easily, as long as I know where that separation is. So just some quick tips for cleaner programs, starting, put a gap in between your weight codes, maybe 5, maybe 10 if you want to. You got plenty to choose from. Just helps with the numerical order of the program itself with the weight codes.